Hi everyone, welcome to this new ToonMotion tutorial. In today's video, we'll be looking at how to add vegetation to your project. Let's start by the basic. Let's cover the simple drag and drop. I will come to my vegetation folder, trees, and I will simply drag and drop an asset from the library inside my scene. When I'm releasing my mouse, that object is added to my project. Pretty basic. What you can also do is use the multi-drop. Here, I'm going to click one time on my object and release my mouse. And once I've done that, now this object is under my mouse. And now at each time I'm going to click in my viewport, this will add the object to my scene. So it's a quick way to add some trees or some vegetation assets to your project. You can also use the multi-drop to place down a selection of assets. So here I'm going to select the Northwest Spruce, I'm going to press Ctrl on my keyboard, click on the Austrian Pine, and let's say also I want maybe to add that Koyama Spruce. So here I've selected three different trees. Now they are all under my mouse, and at each time I'm going to click in the viewport, ToonMotion will randomly select one of them. And it will add it to the project. So it's a quick way to add more variation and randomness to your project. When you add a tree from the library to the viewport, by default, it's added at its medium age. But each tree in ToonMotion comes in three different age. So let's have a look at that. So here I'm just going to place the same tree three times. The one on the left, I'm going to select him. And on the right, in the property panel, here the first option we can see is the age. So here we can play with the age of that specific tree that I have selected. I'm going to lower the age of this one. I'm going to select the third one, and I'm going to raise the age of that one. And here, as you can see, it's really the shape of the tree that has evolved over time. It's not just a basic scale. We can really see that Northwest Spruce started pretty young with that shape. Then it evolved, get thinner, and we have some branch a bit all over. But the adult version that is most likely to grow inside a forest lost some of the branches and leaves towards the bottom of the tree trunk to have more foliage towards the top. So as you can see here, it's really the evolution of the tree across several years. In the property panel, we have other options. Like here, we can change the season. This specific tree doesn't have any season because it's a pine tree. Let's have a look maybe at an apple tree. So here, I'm going to type apple. I'm going to drag and drop that apple tree. So here, as we can see, we have some apple growing on that tree. Let me select it. I can switch to the summer version, autumn, and winter. In the details, there are even options to customize the color of the leaves, the bark, disable the growth that we are going to cover a bit later, and finally disable the wind. Often, the position of a tree is defined in your CAD software. So here, in my viewport, you can see some white box. It's the folder that I have in my scene graph called Tree Placeholder. In that case, that tree came from my CAD software. I created a basic box, a dummy, to position the tree where I wanted them precisely. And now, in ToonMotion, I can replace them all at once by some ToonMotion 3D trees. So what I'm going to do here is click on select my folder. I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to click on replace object. This opens that property panel, the replace object panel. Now what I'm going to do is search for the tree I want in my project. Let's say for example this tree is supposed to be an Indian sandalwood. I'm going to drag and drop that tree in that drop box. And I'm going to click on start replacement. This will replace automatically all the box, all the dummies, by that ToonMotion tree I have added to the folder. And because it's a tree, it takes a random color variation and a random scale just to break up a repetition. So as you can see here, now we have those tree that has been placed in the exact correct position defined by my CAD software. While adding trees one by one is pretty cool, you can precisely place the object where you want, you can also use the paint tool to populate a large area very quickly. So here I will come to the populate dock at the bottom of the screen. I'm going to click on foliage and I will start with the paint tool. Here, same idea, I have a drop box that I can expand and I will need to drop assets here to start painting them. So here, let's say I want to paint the same tree, so the Northwest spruce. I'm going to add that tree once. I will select my brush and now I can start to paint my tree on my terrain. When you use the paint tool, it creates a layer that you can then edit afterwards. The layer is defined by those small green triangles that you can see on screen right now. If you don't want to see them, you can just press G on your keyboard to hide them. So now that my layer has been defined, I can then further customize it. So let's say I want to add a new tree to that layer. I can simply take my Austrian pine and add it in my dropbox. This will scatter that new tree on my layer that I have set up. Now let's say I actually don't want that much Austrian pine. I can select that specific tree species and I can lower the density of this one. You can also change the scale of one specific tree in that property panel. So let's say that the Northwest spruce here, I want maybe this one to be at an adult age. I'm going to the age slider and I'm going to grow this one. Let's say maybe in that forest there is the same tree species but in different age. I can drag and drop another time the Northwest spruce inside that drop box. That second time here, I will leave him at 50%. And I will add him a third time, and this one I'm going to make it a young version. So here we have three times the same tree, one at an adult age, one at a medium age, and one at a young age. Even after that, I can customize the density of each tree. So for example, if I want to have more adult variant, I will select the adult, and I will just raise the density of this one. Let's say now I want a slightly larger area, so I can paint more. I can obviously also change the diameter of my brush. But now what I want to do is add a bit of ground cover in that forest. So let's come back in the folder. Now I will enter, let's start maybe with some rocks actually. To add a new asset, same thing, I will drag and drop it in that dropbox. Here, there is a bit too much rock, so I will select my rock and just lower the density. Going to do the same maybe with that smaller one here. Same thing, I can change the density. Maybe a third one. That one, yeah, something like that. Let's say that now I want to add some bushes. I will come to my vegetation, bushes, and same thing, I can drag and drop some vegetation asset in the folder like that. Those bush here looks a bit too bright for the forest, so what I'm going to do is select one, I will come to the details, and I can change the tint of that one. Also, if I want to change the color of the fern on all of them at once, I can simply select all of them and edit the color of all of them at once. In my paint tool, I can also add some grass. So let's get a bit closer to the ground. And here I will come to the grass folder and we can maybe add some dry wild grass. So here it's scattered all around some grass, so we don't even see the ground anymore. So it's a quick way to make your terrain look way more realistic and add details to it. As you can see here, in just a couple of clicks, in a couple of, let's say 1 minute with all the speaking, I've really vegetalized that whole area in front of our project. While the paint tool can be used on really large area like that, it can also be used on some smaller spaces. Let's come closer to our project to show you another example. We'll come over here and I will come back in my folder to the MISC folder. Here we have some IVs. So Ivy, you can use some of the one at the bottom of the folder that you can place down manually one by one like that. So I can make, I can have some coming from the ground, that's the growing Ivy. We have some that fall, that's the falling Ivy. So here you can place something like that, but you can also use the paint tool to paint some Ivy. What I'm going to do now is come back to the populate panel. I'm again in the paint tool, and here I want to use the brushable Ivy. I'm going to drop that one here. I will select my brush and I will just set up a really small diameter, something like 0.2 maybe. I will come closer to my project and now I can start to paint that Ivy directly on my building. Obviously, on that specific project, it's not perfectly suited to have some Ivy growing on the glass, but it's just to give you the idea. So here, I'm just again painting exactly where I want that Ivy. So it's a really quick way to visualize some pieces of your project. So now that we cover the paint tool, let's have a look at the scatter tool. Going back a bit so we can have a big picture of our project. I will come to the populate tool, and actually before using the tool, I want to show you something. Here, I will click somewhere in my viewport to select, for example, that mesh. When using the scatter tool, it will scatter the selected object on the geometry you will be clicking on. Let's just raise that mesh above the terrain so we better see what will be happening in that part of the video. So now what I'm going to do is come to the populate, vegetation, scatter. I'm going to drag and drop the Norwest spruce in my Dropbox. With this tool, I need to select the asset I want to add to my scene, and I will need to click on my scatter tool to activate it. Now that my tool is activated, where I will click, it will start to add the selected object. So here, once I start to click on my mesh, it will add the trees onto that geometry and nowhere else. Let's say I want to add it to that piece of the terrain. So as you can see here, it's a really large square that is going a bit beneath my road. So if I click over here, this will, same idea, this will scatter the tree on that wall mesh. That mesh is going underneath the road. That means that we have some chance that we have some tree going under it and that will collide with the road. To fix that, you can simply select your eraser and just erase the tree that are just where you don't need them. Of course, you can use the scatter tool to scatter tree, but also smaller objects like bushes. So if I come a bit closer to that mesh here, I'm going to select again my scatter tool. This time I'm going to add some bushes. I'm going to add them in my Dropbox. Maybe also this one. And again, this doesn't work similar as the paint tool. It doesn't have a layer system. That means if you want to add those to your project, you need to select them, you need to activate the scatter tool and click somewhere in your scene to add them. Same thing here. Let's say I don't want some of those assets over the small puddle that we have here. I will just select the asset I want to erase. I'm going to enable the eraser, going to set the diameter, and I'm just going to erase the asset where I don't want them. You can use the scatter tool on large area like that, but also on smaller one. So let's say the top of our project here is not a water material. Let's say it's actually some grass. So I'm going to the library, materials, ground, nature, and I'm going to add that grassy material onto that geometry. I will come back to the foliage here. I will come back to my populate, scatter, and here what I want to add is some lawn. I'm going to drag and drop this. I'm going to select it, click on scatter, and I'm going to click on my mesh. As you can see here, it started to add some grass onto that geometry. So you can work in smaller area like that. Right now, it's lacking a bit density. So what you can do is click a couple of times to add more density. What you can also do, let's actually remove everything. What you can also do here is just drag and drop the loan a couple of times in your Dropbox. So when you will just add that to your project, it will have more density by default. Now let's come to the ambience, and here I'm going to open the weather details. Here we have a vegetation growth option. The growth defines the age of all the trees that you have added inside your project. So here I have some trees in young, medium and adult age, we have some bush, we have a bit of everything. So here, if I'm starting to work with this slider, you will see all the vegetation surrounding your project. You will see it evolve over time. You can use this option to present your project at delivery when the project will be built, but then you can also showcase how it will look like maybe 10 or 20 years later. There is a bit of wind on the trees, but it's just happening on the leaves themselves, as we can see here. You can increase the wind in the environment, weather details, here we have a wind speed, so you can increase that. But it will never make your tree trunk move. To do that, I have a small tips that I'm going to show you in that video. So the first thing I'm going to do here is add the Northwest spruce inside my project. I'm going to make this one an adult version. Now what I'm going to use is a rotator. So I will come back to the library, come back to tools, animators, rotator. I'm going to drag and drop that rotator inside my scene. The first thing here I want is that the axis of my rotator should be at 90 degrees. Like that. I'm going to place that rotator exactly in the middle of my tree trunk. And now I'm going to make that Northwest spruce a child of that rotator. It will look weird, but after a couple of settings, it will be a bit better. So I will select my tree to make it a child. I can just move it underneath the rotator itself in the scene graph. So I told you, right now, it looks a bit weird. The first thing I want to do here is set the animation to ping pong, so it will move and come back to its original position. Now I'm going to change the animation speed, something like 0.01 to start with. Now what I want to change is the angle of that animation, 90 degrees, way too much. For that tree, let's start by maybe something like 4 degrees. So right now it starts straight and it's bending 4 degrees to the left. To not have the tree just bending 4 degrees to the left, what I'm going to do is give him 2 degrees to the right. So it will go 2 degrees to the left, 2 degrees to the right. So here it's bending a bit in all directions. Right now it's maybe a bit too fast, so I will select back my tree, rotator, and I'm going just to define 0.005, something like that. It's not because the minimum value of a slider is here that you can't type the value you want in the box itself. So here I just type that lower value. I'm pretty happy with the result. Now what I can do is duplicate that rotator. So I'm going to select the rotator in the scene graph and I'm going to duplicate it a couple of times in my scene. So it's not perfect, but just a quick tip on how you can add a bit of animation to your project. And that's it for this video on the vegetation. Thank you everyone for watching it, and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone!